So I'm so excited about this piece. Why? Because I got epoxy to lay flat and it dried. Amazing, huh? I did have to put a little bit of silicone in it, and so it kind of made it a little bit cloudy, but overall, I am totally happy. This was a cheap project. I got the frame at the Deseret Industries here, which is kind of like Goodwill, and I hope you can find something similar out there with a frame in it. And once you do a nice pour, you can just pour in some epoxy and you don't have to worry about running everywhere. All right, here we go. Today I'm going to be going over the mixtures of paint a lot better than I do on other videos, because I get so many questions of people asking me, how much glue do I use? How much floetrol do I use? How much white? How much water? How much silicone? And all that. So I just want to clear that up and do a video for that. I use a glue all formula. This is just regular Elmer's glue, and the glue all is 30% stronger than the regular Elmer's glue. So I think that makes a difference. It should say now stronger formula. So many other videos talk about PVA. Well, exactly what is PVA? PVA is simply Elmer's glue or white school glue, but they also make a more expensive brand of PVA. The inexpensive kind is the Elmer's glue, which is not acid free. It will most likely turn yellow over a long period of time. It won't maintain the consistency like high quality PVAs that are pH balanced and all that, but it will do a great job for years to come, and it's great for learning how to paint right now. The expensive kind is archival museum quality. It's acid free, it won't yellow, and it's pH balanced, so it will last a very long time. But look at the price discrepancies. It's $16 a gallon for Elmer's glue, and $47 a gallon for the Line Co. Neutral pH Adhesive PVA. So it's basically your choice. I use a cheap Apple Barrel White you can find at Walmart. It's not technically cheap. I mean, it's still, you know, kind of expensive for paint. But I use the gloss, not the matte. You don't want to use the matte paint because you'll get a lot different results and it will crack too. You don't want crack. And I also use floetrol, and I will put up the graphic of the floetrol. Floetrol is a water-based paint conditioner. It helps to improve paint flow and workability. It also allows the paint to adjust to more difficult conditions such as hot, cold, and windy environments. It increases translucency for artistic effects like pouring. It helps against crazing and cracking and against bubbles forming, and it's flexible and non-yellowing. Floetrol can be found at Home Depot, on Amazon.com, at Lowe's, and even Walmart. And then distilled water, I just have a little squirt bottle of that. And for this, I seriously got this at a place out here in Utah called the DI, or Deseret Industries. And it's, you know, it's a little bit tore up. It had a little chunk right here, so I kept painting over it and painting over it right here. But I sprayed this Krylon sea glass. This is really cool stuff. It does look like sea glass. So let's get into some of the mixing. This is where I'm carefully going to show you how to mix your paint. This is how I mix it. I'm just showing you what I do. If your results may vary depending on what state, where you live, how cold it is, the humidity levels and everything. So I'm going to start out with some Floetrol, some glue, and then I'm going to use, I'm going to start out with some Artist Loft Ultramarine paint. So I'm going to put in a squirt of floetrol. I'm gonna have to set that there. And then I'm going to put in a squirt of glue. So the cup is now to the bottom ring on these little cups. Another thing about using the glue and the floetrol, you don't have to use as much paint. Personally, I don't even know why he's putting these videos together, because he doesn't know what he's doing. It's seriously so awesome that way. The more times you say serious, the more seriously people take you. So now I'm gonna put in just about that much paint. Wipe it off there so I don't get a little edge later. So now let's go to mixing. So the longest part about this video is going to be the mixing. I want you to get good at the mixing part, because if you get good at the mixing part, then you won't have any troubles getting cells. And this has been really a carefree formula for me. I mix my base coats a little heavier. So what I mean by a base coat is some paints I want as kind of the bottom, and then when I swipe over it, those will be my top coats, if that makes any sense. So this ultramarine is going to be a base coat. So that is a little thicker than the melted ice cream, as I say. It's just, I don't know, that's about melted ice cream too, I don't know. But that'll be perfect. So I'm gonna set that aside. I'm not gonna put silicone in there yet. Let's do the white. The white, I already have some Floetrol and glue in there. So I'm kind of cheating on showing you the mix there. But I'm going to show it to you anyways. So, man, I keep using a little too much paint because there's not going to be that much. So my white, I like to have it a little bit thinner. So I'm gonna add just a dab of glue because I don't want it that thick. And then a little more Floetrol because I want it thinner. The Floetrol will thin it out for sure. And it's always good to have clean rags and newer ones in case a paint spills, and you wanna go like that, and that way you don't get it on the carpet and you have to pay for new carpet. Or if you're in the garage, you still won't have to clean up as much. So the white is a pretty good mix already. I might use just a dash of water to get it just a little bit thinner. Again, I'm kind of cheating on the white because I already had that going on. Okay, so that's about like microwaved sour cream. It's a little bit thinner than the melted ice cream consistency. That's the best I can explain it. So put in a dash of Floetrol. And as far as my parts, okay, that sounded weird. As how many parts that I use to paint, I use about one part paint, 2 to 3 parts Floetrol, and about 3 to 5 parts glue. and sometimes the glue and Floetrol will be about the same. It depends on how thick your paint is. I just love this color, this metallic cobalt blue. It is so awesome. So you can see it in there. I've got my Halloween screen on back here. It's kind of dark. I don't know if you could see that or not. I hope I'm getting everything in the camera here. And you want to make sure that your paint is really mixed up well. And that's just a pretty awesome mix. Gosh, I'm going to have a ton left over. Let me use this aqua. So a little Floetrol. Little glue in there. So that's about half and half right there. Excuse me. And seriously, you can experiment just a little with this formula. Yeah, much better. See how this one just already comes out creamy smooth? I don't know what it is about the light blue that really sucks. And I'm gonna do just a dash more Floetrol to thin it up just a hair. And the key to getting big cells is coming up. Saving the best for the last. All right, so now we need a little metallic phthalo green. Phthalo. Like that. And I'm gonna do a dirty pour. Gonna get a dirty pour going on. Dirty pour, that's such a funny term. Dirty pour flip cup. Dirty pour flip cup. If you're new at this and you wanna learn some new wild fun techniques, look up Anne Marie Ritterhoff on YouTube. Got a little green on me going. It's good, I'm getting into it. And I forgot to say the colors of these. This is phthalo green, and that's with a P. P-T-H. Halo. P-H-T and then halo. H-A-L-O. And this is metallic. The other one was metallic cobalt blue, and then the other was Basics brand bright aqua green by Liquitex Basics. Okay, so I think that's good for the paint mixing. I'm gonna set these up. And I'm going to show you how to do your silicone. This is the most important feature. I think a lot of people that watch these videos think the more silicone, the better. The more cells we're going to get, the bigger cells. Wrong. Time out. Actually, the more silicone, the less cells you get. The right amount of silicone, you get lots of cells. But the more you go, the less
cells you're going to get. The more you mix the silicone into the paint, the smaller the cells are going to be. That's my opinion. Other people might say different with different mixes. This is what I think is good on my mix. So about right here, I'm gonna drop in my silicone. You wanna be careful, this silicone thing leaks, and so that's why I kinda put it in this little bucket thing. So I'm gonna do 3 drops, 1, 2, 3. You see how little that is. It's not very much at all. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. That's not a lot of silicone. Before, when I first started out, I was like using the spray silicone, and this, I was like just pouring it in. I was like, man, what's going on? I'm not getting the cells I wanted. So the next step to that, you got the silicone dropped in there. Just go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3. So I do a stir per drop. Let's move these out. And I might grab this extra white just in case I need a little more white. I have some more down here. Just in case. And it already has the silicone in it. So let's do our pour. And I'm gonna go with some white first. Then I'm going to lay down some ultramarine to one side. Sometimes I like to see if putting it on one side or whatever makes a difference. Then I'm going to go some phthalo. Can't ever say that right. And I'm going to go some light. And you should start to see a little cells start forming in there. I can see little tiny ones right now. Then I'm gonna go some more white. And I'm gonna save this cup to the side. I'm going to do another cup, and I'm going to go ahead and pour in the rest of that white. Oh, I could have just used this cup. Crikeys. Yeah, let's do that. Get it all in there. I really hope this upper camera is still rolling. And I'm gonna put all of this in. And all of this in. And I forgot, I think I'm just gonna do, I'm not gonna do a flip cup, I'm gonna do a pour. And all of this in. No, I'll tell you what, I'll do a flip cup. No, I better do a pour, because I don't want to do it in here in my office, because it'd be too dangerous. So 1, 2 stirs, and that's all for that one. And I'm gonna go around the edges. Thank you. Okay, so let me get all the edges going on. Let me get my swipe tool, my palette knife, and I'm going to make sure that I get all those edges covered good. And I might do a little swipe to just get this going. Okay, now the next one. I think that should be plenty enough paint. I'm gonna get my bigger palette knife. And I'm gonna rock this puppy down like that. Then this is a little too big, darn it. Dad nabbit. So I'm gonna have to use this one. Alright, so there we go. Now let's shake this up a bit. And let's hit it with the heat gun to see if any more cells will pop up. Oh yeah. You can see some of those cells popping up there. I really like this. I think it's cool. It's kind of like a nebula look. And so, just so you know, this is not what creates cells. It's the silicone. See how I go over it? Just flash it, and that should be it. If you don't get any cells at all, and then you're trying to do that with the embossing tool, it's not gonna work. You might get a few, but it means your mix wasn't right. So anyhow, I really love this one. Could tell I got a few little spots here and there. That's okay. I can touch those up with a few drops of paint. I got some paint over here on the edge, so I might go across like so. And get that off. I might go grab some Q-tips and just get down in there. But other than that, I'm gonna stop now and then I'll show you the drying stages. Okay, here we are. I just brought this in to the kitchen to get it balanced right, because I didn't want this one to start moving around on me. And I'm really loving
some of the cell action going on there. Well, that one looks like an eyeball. Okay. And another thing that people ask me, oh, this dried kind of flat looking, that's okay. Once you gloss coat it, it will, all those little colors will come back. So it has some really fun stuff going on in there. The light reflecting up there on it.
So this is with the epoxy on there. I think it turned out really well. It did get a little cloudy on me because I had to mix some silicone in with the epoxy to get it to lay down. But I'm really happy with this piece, and I hope it inspires you to do one of your own. So go out and find some frames at the Goodwill or Deseret Industries or other similar stores, secondhand shops.
Hello? I don't even know why I'm here.